am I fighting to live if I'm just living to fight? Why am I trying to see when there ain't nothing in sight? Why am I trying to give when no one gives me a try? Why am I dying to live if I'm just living to die? Hi Pisces, welcome back to your daily reading. So that was the channeled song that I heard for you today after meditating on your energy. And it's by Tupac and the Notorious B.I.G. And it's called Running, Dying to Live. Yeah, so those were the lyrics that I heard. And I shuffled the Rider Waite deck and this is what I got for you. So first I pulled the World card. But it was in reverse, and I've got a strong energy of someone living in their ego. Yeah, the kind of ego where you feel like you have to be like the top dog, I'm hearing. Yeah, you're that kind of guy. So basically, you're focused on material. You're focused on the material world. That's what I'm getting. Yeah, so you're not really into spirituality, that's what I'm feeling. You're more a materialistic, ego kind of driven person. Yeah, so that's the kind of person you are. But it's in reverse, so I'm getting that you're struggling with your ego, that's how I feel. Maybe you once was that top dog, but now you kind of, you know, you're not up there at the top no more. That's how I'm feeling. Yes, and next up all the Three of Wands. So I see you here looking back at your past where you was that top kind of guy. You was the top of the top, I'm hearing. Yeah, everyone probably looked up to you in the past. That's what I'm getting. Because, you know, you was materially driven kind of thing. But I see you looking back at the past. So I feel like you're living in fear. That's what I'm getting. You're living in fear. You're living in fear that you're not that person anymore that you used to be. You're not the top dog anymore. So I feel like, yeah, the ego is driven by fear. That's what I'm getting. You're fearing, you know, that you're not as successful as you used to be. That's what I'm getting. Yeah, so next up all the Lovers card. And with this card, I sense a lot of sexual chemistry. So I'm getting you the type of person who has slept with a lot of people, male or female. There's no gender, but whoever you are, I feel like you slept with a lot of people throughout your life. Yeah, I'm just hearing like catching bodies and not the type of catching bodies where you've murdered someone. I feel like you're carrying a lot of bad energy, negative energy from all these past sexual relations that you've had. Yeah, you're carrying a lot of toxic energy within your sacral chakra. That's what I'm getting, because the amount of bodies you've slept with has kind of overcome your sacral chakra. It's taken it over. That's what I'm getting. So you're carrying a lot of bad negative energy in your sacral. Yeah, so next I pulled the Two of Swords in reverse. So I feel like you was led to believe that this is how life should be, living through ego. Yes, people around you and your upbringing, for example, you was taught that the guy at the top, the best dressed person, for example, the people that, you know, who got there doing wrong things are the best people. And I feel like you've been blindly, you know, you've been blindly living, like you've been shown the wrong way in life. That's what I feel. And I'm feeling like it's kind of causing some kind of, you know, depression by living in this fear. That's what I'm getting. Yeah, so next up all the Nine of Swords as well. So there's a lot of sword energy here. So I feel like, I don't know whether it's like a spiritual attack or some kind of depression that you're going through at the moment. And it's because you feel like you're not in the place that you should be in.
Yeah, you feel like you should be still at the top. So you're living in the past. That's what I'm getting. And this is creating you to be depressed. So you might be going through like the dark night of the soul, where you're constantly depressed and living in fear because of past, you know, choices, past decisions, past mistakes that you probably made. Yeah, I see you fighting with self in these, during these spiritual attacks. I feel like you feel like you should be the same as everyone else around you. So maybe you're around a lot of top dogs, I'm getting, but you're not on their level. So you feel like you should be, you know, the same or maybe better than these people because of all the things that you've achieved throughout your life. But, you know, you're not that person. So it's like a case of looking around yourself and seeing if it's the people around you that are causing this depression, the people around you that are causing you to go through these spiritual attacks. The people around you could be, you know, bad for you. That's what I'm getting. That is what is causing you to live in ego and depression and fear. That's what I'm getting. Yes, and next up, all the Queen of Cups. And I'm getting you as raised by a queen. You was raised by a very caring, loving, kind female who, you know, nurtured you and brought you up to be, you know, that top guy or that top girl that they wanted to see. So maybe, you know, you're the kind of person who wants to make mommy proud and you're always trying to achieve that. But, you know, I feel like you've been making her proud in the wrong kind of ways because you've been led down the wrong path. That's what I'm getting. Yeah, so next I got the Seven of Pentacles in reverse. And I feel like you was building, but the things you was building was not, you know, really needed in life. So maybe you focus more on materialistic kind of living. Yeah, and that was your main goal. But I'm getting your focus was not on self. You didn't focus on losing that ego. You didn't focus on losing the fear. You didn't focus on living in the present moment. You're living in the past. You're living in fear and ego, materialistic things that are very low vibrational. So I'm getting that you've just been living at a very low frequency and you probably haven't realized this, and that's probably why you're going through the dark night of the soul and you're depressed right now. Yes, and next up, all the Page of Swords in reverse. Yeah, like I said, you've been led down the wrong path by many people. People taught you that the best way to be that top dog was to, you know, sell drugs, I'm hearing, you know, have swag, have the best clothes, have the latest, you know, slang, music, whatever. But it wasn't about that. It wasn't about that at all. It was about being on your life path. It was about losing that ego. It was about losing the, you know, materialistic side of yourself. It was about working on self and finding love, real true love. But you didn't know that. You thought it was about, you know, stacking the paper, being that top dog and showing off. That's what I'm getting. Yeah, so next I pulled the Hermit in reverse. So I feel like there's a need for solitude that will help you to discover yourself. When you go into solitude, you might feel alone. Maybe that's how you feel now, like you're completely alone in this world. But you're not, I'm getting, because this message is for somebody. So I'm getting that you should be on your life path, but you didn't know. No one told you, no one taught you this. So you're not really seeking that solitude to help yourself. You're feeling depressed instead, because depressed means depressed. So maybe that's what you need. You need a deep rest where you can heal and cleanse yourself from all these situations that are causing you to vibrate at a low frequency. That's what I'm getting. So for the Nine of Cups, And I see a lot of emotions here that you may have blocked during your journey. An awful lot of emotions you're carrying, not to mention all the, you know, sexual partners you're carrying, all the, you know, karmic situations you may have been faced with in life. So there's a lot of karma that's surrounding you right now, and that's why you might feel like, you know, you're not good enough, or you don't know why you're continuing to live this life, because, you know, you're just fighting on to die kind of thing. You forgot that God sent you here for a purpose, and that you need to find that purpose. And the way to find the purpose is to heal yourself first, to heal yourself, and, you know, bring in these changes that are needed for you to find your purpose. Yeah, so next up are the Eight of Swords. And I feel like you feel like you're a failure because you're not that top guy anymore. And it's not the truth, Pisces. I also got a strong feeling of you wanting to die because you feel better off dead. Do you know what I mean? You're thinking to yourself, why should I be here? What am I here for? I'm not the top guy anymore. So you're kind of living in disappointment, I'm getting. You're disappointed with yourself. But it's not that, Pisces. It's not that you're a bad person or a failure. You know, God sent you here for a reason, I'm getting. But you need to find that reason. And this will bring back the, you know, the love of life for you. Yeah, you need to find love, I'm getting. Real, true love. And, you know, open your heart chakra, because that's where you'll let the love come in. Maybe it's blocked from seeing that you're here to love. And that's the main goal. So you're living in fear, which is a very low vibration. And you're thinking of the easy way out instead of doing, you know, that healing that's needed to help yourself, to improve yourself. To, you know, find God, I'm getting, to find real true love. So I asked for some clarity on the whole situation, and I'm getting the King of Pentacles. This will be you in the future. You will be of top status, but not in the material sense, I'm getting, even though this card does mean material wealth and, you know, things like that. But that will come to you in the end after you've done the soul work. You will receive gifts like that. You will receive material gifts. You will receive, you know, that status that you're looking for if you find your way, if you find God, if you find love, I'm getting. Because the way you were seeking that attention and that success before was the wrong way, I'm getting. The correct way will be when you find your purpose. That is when you will become the person that you should be, and that is when you'll receive all the gifts that, you know, God wants you to receive. And this is your message, Pisces. So I hope you do the right thing and you work on yourself and you heal yourself, because that is the correct path for you.